Most snakes in the Susquehanna Valley are harmless, but there are a few with a dangerous bite. One News 8 viewer wanted to know how to tell the difference. It turns out there's an easy way to do that when it comes to the venomous copperhead. News 8's naturalist Jack Hubley shows us in this morning's Wild Moment.
Here in the Susquehanna Valley, it's good to know that most of the snakes we encounter are harmless. Still, there is the outside chance that you might cross paths with a venomous copperhead or timber rattlesnake. And that outside chance was on Bill Wilkinson's mind when he ran into this little guy in his yard in Pine Grove. He writes, "We were cleaning up in the flowers on the bank when I spotted it. Not the usual garter snake, and about 6 to 8 inches long. When I approached, it rattled its tail, coiled, and struck out. Quite aggressive. I captured it with the old snake under the Folgers can trick. When released, it kept coiling and striking. Hope we did not release a poisonous critter in the retirement community. Bill, you'll be happy to know that there's no need to lose sleep over this one. Your little snake is a young eastern milk snake, totally harmless. This one is probably one of this year's babies. Don't worry about that tail rattling. Many species of non-venomous snakes vibrate their tails when they feel threatened. In dry leaves, it can sound very much like a rattlesnake. Here's what your baby milk snake will look like when he grows up. So, how do we know he's not a copperhead? After all, he is kind of a coppery color. Well, take a look at the head. It's small, not much wider than the neck. And those blotches on the milk snake are outlined in black. Now, let's take a look at the copperhead. And the first thing we're going to look at is the head, and it is triangular shaped, well, just like a rattlesnake would be as well. But it's the blotches that are the real tip-off. If you look at those bands that go around the body, the dark bands, you'll notice that they all pinch tight as they go up over the spine, and they get wide as they go down the sides, just like an hourglass or a bow tie. So, just remember that here in the East, the copperhead is the only snake that gets dressed up for you and wears bow ties. And those eastern milk snakes and northern water snakes, well, they're just harmless copperhead wannabes. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
And if you have a wildlife question for Jack, just email it to news8@wgal.com. And you may just see the answer right here on the air.